us this evening, direct our councillors in all their deliberations tonight. We are going through uncertain times, and many people are anxious about where it will all end. But we believe that our councillors will do their best and make the right decisions for the people of the local communities. Bless us all, so that at the end of the day, we may achieve what is required for the greater good of all. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
I have been notified of the following apologies. Councillor Mary Jordan. Are there any further apologies? Right, on behalf of the members, I would like to extend a warm welcome to the meeting for those who have attended to hear the Council discuss the recommendation from the Freedom Panel to create a new Honorary Freewoman and a new Honorary Freeman Posthumous Award. I would like to invite the Leader of the Council, Councillor Pat Hackett, to formally move a motion.
So move, Mr. Mayor.
I would like to invite Councillor Ian Lewis to second.
Second, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you.
Councillor Hackett, you now have 5 minutes to speak to the motion.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. It gives me great pleasure to be able to give my support to these nominations for Freedom of the Borough, the highest award the Council can bestow. I know Councillor Blakely has carried out much research into the history of Lieutenant J. Frederick Simpson, and he used to be telling us a bit more about Blakely. But just briefly, he was an American pilot stationed near here during World War II, but being on a test flight when his plane caught fire. It's clear Lieutenant Simpson showed considerable heroism in flying his plane away from Holmes in Sorghum Massey in 1944. Sacrificing his life, aged just 27, to protect others. His sacrifice truly deserves this recognition. The other nomination, Dr. Batali, who I'm sure many of you will know of, and who has been a prominent member of our community for many years. She was, of course, head of the Italian Consular Office based just off Hamilton Square in Birkenhead for more than 20 years after moving to Wirral with her husband, Alberta. As an honorary consul, she received no payments and self-funded her work, providing consular support across the Northwest. But her work promoting the Italian language and culture means many local people have benefited from her involvement in our community over the years. In addition to her consular work, Dr. Batali has played a major role in supporting the teaching of Italian and Italian culture in world schools. She also played a key role, of course, we will remember those of us here, we've been here for a while, in twinning with the Italian province of Latina as part of this wider sharing of culture. Some may also remember her involvement in the Council's Euro-Wirral initiative in the 1990s and early 2000s. A programme which brought significant resources, of course, to the borough at the time. There's much that we can thank Dr. Batali for, Vitali and the Lieutenant Simpson be given the freedom of the borough. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you.
Do any other councillors wish to speak on the motion?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, it's an honour and a privilege to nominate Second Lieutenant J. Frederick Simpson, a brave airman, born 26th of August 1916 in Gillette, Wisconsin, who sadly died on 9th of January 1944 aged 27, saving lives in Silver Massey by flying his stricken plane away from President George. Second Lieutenant Simpson was basic US Army Air Force Base Bitten Ward during the latter part of World War II. And it is reported that he was test flying a Republic Thunderbolt P-47, which is taken off from Bitten Ward and flew out to sea. On his return over Hoy Lake, he reported that the plane was on fire. I understand it sailed over the RAF camp at West Kirby, when it was seen to lose height and flip over before crashing. And as I said before, he flew his plane away from residential areas, clearly an heroic act. In 1974, pieces of the wreckage were dug up by the Moorhead Plane Investigation Group, and they were placed at Fort Birch Rock. His gold-class signet ring was found in the wreckage and was presented to his cousin, Rose Neil Godfrey, who in turn gave it to Lieutenant Simpson's local Legion post, the Crown Simpson Post 300, in Gillette, Wisconsin. Unfortunately, I understand a few days later, the Legion post was broken into and his ring was stolen. Having made the nomination, I was pleased that in July, on a trip down to Cambridge, I visited the American Cemetery and Memorial where Lieutenant Simpson's body is interred. And with the help of staff there, I found his plot, his grave, and was able to pay my respects at his graveside. Mr. Mayor, during the power of social media, I posted that on Facebook and I received a message within 2 days from a lady called Lachelle Simpson, who lives in Billings, Montana. Lachelle Simpson is J. Frederick Simpson's great granddaughter, and she was obviously delighted. She put me in touch with her father, his namesake, J. Simpson, who lives in a town called Pryor in Montana. He is a pastor, and we had a quite long time and conversation about this matter, and he and his family are absolutely delighted with this nomination and with this service, hopefully to be bestowed upon his grandson. And the whole family, I'm told, are watching this tonight on webcast. They send their apologies for not being able to come over, but it is on the way away. It's 7 hour time, it's 10:30 in the morning their time. And I'm hoping that they, through the webcast, accept this nomination and see council vote for it. It is, or it could be said, that we remember those people who died in all wars. Remember those famous battles. We tend to forget all those who lost their life in support. And Second Lieutenant Simpson was one of those. He didn't die in a dogfight or in a bombing raid. He died test flying a fighter plane that would be used by others. And no doubt the information he gathered from that test flight, although he lost his life, could be used to help others in the quest to bring the war to an end as it did the year later. So, Mr. Mayor, as I said at the outset, I'm honoured and privileged to make this nomination, and I so move.
Have you got any other answers? Thank you, Mr. Wayne.
sacrifice and things like that. Whereas it does mean that secondly, Ted Simpson will never be forgotten by the people of Wirral, and that will go on for as long as Wirral goes on. The other thing I would just like to say is I'd like to associate myself as a former leader of the council with the work that Nuncia, don't mind, I'll call her Nuncia because that's how I know, the work that Nuncia has done for Wirral. She has been an outstanding public servant who has worked tirelessly on our behalf, and I think it is an incredibly fitting honour, and I just wanted to make my views known regarding the work that she did, and she's done for me as leader, I'm sure for other leaders, right across the years for Wirral. She is an outstanding public servant, and I'm delighted that we're to honour her this way.
Includes